I'm Alex Villarreal with the VOA Special English Development Report. Last week, we told you about Failfair, an event where people talk about international development projects that failed. Many of these projects started as good ideas. Others had some level of success, but not enough to have a measurable effect on the lives of people in developing countries. A nonprofit group in New York City called Mobile Active held the first Failfair earlier this year. Mobile Active is made up of people and organizations that use technology to try to improve the lives of the poor. Katrine Verklaas came up with the idea for Failfair as a way to help nonprofit groups improve by learning from the mistakes of others. She says the primary goal is to learn from failure and not to repeat the same mistakes over and over again. Katrine Verklaas says there are many reasons why projects fail, but one reason tops all others. She says development projects are not one size fits all. Yet, many people try to import ideas as if they were. What they fail to consider, she says, is the desires of the local people, or their cultural, economic, and political differences. She says the problem for many non-governmental organizations and other groups is simply not knowing their audience. The creator of Failfair says this is true not only with technology, but other projects as well. Ms. Verklaas hopes nonprofits in other industries and fields will create their own versions of Failfair. A second Failfair took place in July in Washington. The World Bank Institute co-sponsored the event. To Katrine Verklaas, it was a good sign to have the World Bank support such open discussions about failure. She says it is not just about products. It is about people's lives and well-being and livelihoods in many developing countries. So it is important to be very honest about what projects are not performing according to expectations. An award for the best worst failure story went to Michael Trucano from the World Bank Institute. What he presented was in fact a list. It was a list of what he considers the worst practices in the use of information and communication technologies in education. Mr. Trucano gets to keep the award until the next Failfair, which is expected to be held on the West Coast this fall. You can find a link to his list of the top 10 worst practices at voaspecialenglish.com. For VOA Special English, I'm Alex Villarreal.